Are you struggling with rounded shoulders and poor posture? Discover the best stretches to increase flexibility in tight areas. Progress these strength moves as well for well-balanced shoulders and lasting results. The dislocate exercise is a mobility classic. We're improving shoulder mobility. These are excellent for opening the chest, articulating the scapula through a full range of motion, and creating flexible, strong shoulders. It's time we become familiar with the shoulder dislocate drill. Grip width is based on your level of mobility. Begin with wide hands and progressively narrow the grip as you improve. We want to avoid bending the arms at any stage. Straight elbows during dislocates are a must for proper, effective form. Let's continue with optimal technique, working from the top down. Scapular elevation combined with scapular retraction is correct. Start each rep by shrugging the shoulders up, then pinching the shoulders back. Cueing the scapula in this way allows our arms to move freely overhead and behind our back. Arching the lumbar spine is a common way of cheating. Correct dislocates require a posterior pelvic tilt, glutes squeezed, and tight abs. Speed and intensity are something you'll be monitoring and progressing long term. Everyone should make it their mission to use a dominant tempo. Useful reps require us to smoothly move between positions. Make sure to control the movement from overhead to stick behind the body. Pay particular attention to the transition at the start. This phase is the most challenging as our chest and shoulders are at peak stretch. Dislocates are always going to feel somewhat uncomfortable, but you should never feel pain. Use a hand width session to session, which is demanding yet possible in practice. Sitting on a bench is another way of training our dislocates. This setup flexes the lumbar, which forces the thoracic spine and shoulders to do all of the work. The choice is ultimately yours between variations. Standing, kneeling, and seated all improve shoulder mobility when trained genuinely. Be strict with a dominant tempo to guarantee mobility gains are captured. Lastly, be patient with progressing grip width intra, within, and inter between workouts. The corner stretch helps us improve thoracic rotation. This passive posture increases flexibility of the stubborn upper spine segments. Your patience and dedication with this stretch helps lengthen the chest muscles as well. The corner stretch requires tinkering to find a position which suits. Here's a technique breakdown to get you on the right path. Begin on the ground in full knee flexion. Next, use your hand to block the knee to constrain movement. Now go ahead and position the stretching arm at a 90-90 elbow and shoulder shape. To increase the rotation and stretch sensation, keep the scapula retracted at all times. Don't make the mistake of rounding the back and crunching down. Instead, keep a proud posture and use pure thoracic rotation. To help increase range of motion, a mini contract relax can be incorporated. Isometrically push the bottom hand into the knee and the top arm into the pole. After a few seconds of contracting, release the tension and twist into further rotation. Our last technique cue of importance is breathing. Deep breathing helps with relaxing and increasing our passive range. Calmly inhaling and exhaling is going to make the corner stretch much more effective. Doing so tells the body it's safe to rotate, allowing a greater stretch and more movement. The 90-90 band external rotation is an excellent shoulder stability exercise. This one targets the external rotators on the back of the shoulder, the posterior rotator cuff. You're going to need an appropriate resistance band and stick for these. Anchor the band around head height so there's enough clearance. Begin by abducting your arms so the elbows are about shoulder height. From here, set the scapula into retraction and stay retracted. You're now going to perform external rotation. Do this by rotating the hands so they meet elbow level or slightly further back. The key for successful form involves stationary elbows in the 90 degree position. This requires mindfulness but isn't difficult. We're only holding the weight of a stick. The common mistake is using a band which is too heavy. Clearly, body English is needed and range of motion is rubbish. The other mistake is a floppy band. When there's no tension at the start to mid-range, the exercise won't work so well. Choose an appropriate distance from the anchor with a realistic band difficulty. If you have been paying attention to technique, you'll have noticed the following. Every rep is done explosively into external rotation. This is followed by an end range pause with plenty of effort. Each rep is finished with a controlled return to the start. Lastly, disclaimer incoming. Please don't use old or fraying bands. I don't want anyone getting a silly injury. Everything about the 90-90 band external rotation makes it an optimal movement. We're using a strict posture with a flexed lumbar and fixed shoulder angle. The unique benefit of the band is how resistance works. The tension is perpendicular to our end range contraction. This quick setup means we can build strength in our weakest range without deltoid fatigue. Getting stronger in 90-90 equals robust shoulders overhead mobility.
Do you want to get flexible as an adult? Learn the best stretches for lasting flexibility with Fitness FAQ's workout programs. Shop Fitness FAQs and move freely today.
A fixed bar is one of the best ways for opening our thoracic spine and also shoulders. When the arms are anchored in place, we're able to use our body weight to intensify range of motion. Let's get into it. The active hold is done with the feet and hips above the ground. This means we need a setup which has sufficient height to play with. Stall bars, a Smith machine, or even a barbell in a squat rack are all recommended. Next, grab a yoga block or foam roller to serve as a mobility fulcrum. The ideal placement is on the mid to upper spine, around T7 for my anatomy people. During our bar thoracic hold, keep locked elbows. For most people, shoulder width or slightly further is comfortable and strong. The training technique is easy, lower to end range and hold. Breathe calmly and let the body progressively sink deeper. Nothing forced, nothing impossible. Don't push into pain or go beyond your limits. Active holds are used for shorter duration sets to build strength at length. Always leave enough energy to pull back at the end. The passive hold is with the feet supported, hips above ground. You may prefer the legs bent or the legs straight. Either way, the outcome is similar. Let's continue with the technique. Your goal is to progressively sink the hips closer towards the ground. This will happen naturally over time as you breathe calmly and stretch deeper. It's helpful to focus on the upper body when doing passive training. Think about pointing the chest up towards the sky. Visualize your rib cage expanding, the upper back extending, and the shoulders opening bit by bit. Passive bar holds are all about relaxing, letting go, and allowing the body to enter a new range. Passive holds are programmed for longer sets to build total capacity. The combination of passive and active methods are highly complementary. Passive aims to stretch beyond our previous limits. Active helps us increase usable strength. There's a time and a place for both. Have fun.